Rather, speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into Him who is the head, into Christ.
Hi, this is Tim Hall with the Central Church of Christ in Johnson City, Tennessee. I just became aware of an offer through one of my credit card companies. The offer is a free app for a product called Calm. You may have heard of it, you may use it. It is apparently very popular. There's over 70 million that are using it, I've been told. And it tells me that there's a lot of people looking for calm and peace in their lives. And so here's an app that says we can help you with that. Well, I'm in. Give me a copy of it. I want to try that. But you know, we've always had in our hands the prescription for calm. It's the Word of God. And I want to take you to Psalm 131. This is not a psalm that we talk about very much, but it's a beautiful statement of calm. Listen to what the writer says. It's attributed to David as well. It says, "O Lord, my heart is not lifted up. My eyes are not raised too high. I do not occupy myself with things too great and too marvelous for me." And in saying that, he seems to be saying, I'm content. I'm content with a simple life. Then he goes on in verse 2. "I have calmed and quieted my soul like a weaned child with its mother. Like a weaned child is my soul within me." And that's a very interesting comparison, like a weaned child. It means a child that's probably 3 to 5 years old. They're no longer nursing at their mother's breast, but they still need their mother. And as long as they are within eyesight, when they're being held by their mother, everything is fine. They're calm. And that seems to be the idea. And how do we get that? I mean, where does that come from? He says in verse three, "O Israel, hope in the Lord from this time forth and forevermore." So there's the prescription for calm. We are those weaned children, and God is our mother, so to speak. And as long as we are in His presence, things will be calm. And it brings to my mind the passage in Mark chapter 4. You remember how the disciples were in a boat, and Jesus was with them. He was sleeping in the back of the boat. And this terrible storm came up. This is in Mark chapter 4. And let me just read verses 37 through 39. "A great windstorm arose, and the waves were breaking into the boat, so that the boat was already filling. But he, Jesus, was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him and said to him, 'Teacher, do you not care that we're perishing?' They had no calm in their souls. You can rest assured of that. And then in verse 39, "Jesus awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, 'Peace, be still.' And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm." Imagine the stormy sea, and Jesus speaks the words, and immediately there is a calm. If you read further into chapter 5 of Mark, you'll read about a man that was possessed by demons, a lot of them. He was not a man who had any calmness in his life. And yet when Jesus came into his life, the demons were cast out, the man was calm. That's what we need. We need more of the Lord. We need to go to Him. We need to look to Him like a weaned child needs to depend on the mother. And I love the words of this song that we sometimes sing, "Be Still My Soul." It was a song written by Katrina von Schlegel in the 18th century. And here's what it says in one of the verses. "Be still, my soul. Your God will undertake to guide the future as He has the past. Your hope, your confidence, let nothing shake. All now mysterious shall be bright at last. Be still, my soul. The waves and winds still know His voice who ruled them while He dwelt below." And that's a reminder that peace and calm can still be found with the Lord. Let's pray. Father, thank you for being the master of the oceans and the wind. Thank you for having the power to bring calm out of storm. Father, today, bless us with peace. And that because we know you are our Savior, you are our Lord. Thank you. Thank you for being the Prince of Peace. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's seek the calmness that is found in the Lord.